Hey, Shanti.
I was feeling stuffy doing those emotes, so I have to sketch every once in a while just to loosen back up. Hey, Flothar. A deer woman? I would say more of like an ornament of some sort. Maybe some sort of like native headdress for whatever culture she's from. I don't know. Hello, Mel. Maybe she's Swedish. Covered with butter. Grab a lobster? Lobster. Hello, Mel. She's kind of cute.
Had my hard-earned bits to yours for.
Atsy, thank you for the bits. We'll make this 16. Actually, we'll just do this. Yokai wants her covered with butter. Slabs of butter all over her. Thank you. She's not a crab or a lobster. She's a human being, all right? As far as we know. She's so pretty. Thanks. She takes after me. As her proud father. What else should she have? Mushrooms? Give her mushrooms. A little buddy. How about a snail? A nice dinner for someone special? What did you choose to make? Yeah, a few times. Just random stuff. Steak, fish, the usuals. Morning, mediocre. Morning, Tolfantos. No, it wasn't. Well, I mean, I didn't ask them, but like over time you learn someone's preferences, so it wasn't really a surprise. Lentil soup? I don't think I've ever made lentil soup. For sashimi, you want either white wine or sake. Or beer. I like beer with sushi. The pairing that, I mean, there's been a lot of them. Like, there isn't a specific one that kind of stands out, but Most of the restaurants that you go to that have pairings usually have a separate pairing menu that you can pick from, and that's usually what makes it good or stand out. Favorite part of going to a really good restaurant is when they pair ingredients and dishes that you didn't even think would go together. One place I went to served goat cheese and carrot macaroons. Interesting. Macaroons aren't my favorite dessert. I had a few and when I went to France, and I don't know, there's something about like the smell, like the eggy smell. I think they taste good, but I don't really enjoy the smell a whole lot. It's definitely not the first dessert I would pick, that's for sure. Palette cleanser. Biscuits, like cookies. I like very rich chocolate desserts, like a chocolate lava cake or like chocolate mousse. Chocolate fondant. Thank you. This is not commission work. This is for fun, for funsies work. Or sketching. Imagine sketching for fun, right? Can you think of a time when you sketch for fun? Creepy Mermaid? This one? So nice of Sensei to order a butcher block from all the way there. If you were closer, I would totally commission you to make me stuff, Eli. But if I were to order from you, the shipping would be like $1,000. It would take like 9.5 months to get here. Have Mal do it. Mel is doing it. Yeah. She got Christmas lights on her head or something. Morning, Life Hunt. G21mm. G21mm. What is that from? The Gundam? Yes. Grim? Wait, the 2 is a R? Grim, thank you for the raid. Thank you for spreading the buns. We love bun spreading here. Not a very long time ago at TwitchCon. TwitchCon has been millions of years ago, alright? I can't remember, but I'm a boomer. I can't remember way back then. TwitchCon is but a distant memory. Thank you very much. I haven't been live for a long time, so. I thought it was coming back February 31st, 2022. I have no idea. Wait, what? Will I try touch up and maybe make the Cyber Girl merch? What Cyber Girl merch? Huh? Is there a way to look up kanji? Like, translate it or learn to write it? I don't know. I'm not Japanese. Ah, the hell? It's Photoshop's equivalent to the pen breaking and spilling ink all over. It's always Monday, Bob. Sorry. Merch of the Cyber Girl, you have... Oh! That? I don't know if that'll ever translate very well to merch. Where did I put that even? Done on stream? Stream drawings. Oh yeah, right here. This one? And I don't know how well this would translate to merch. That took you so long to do? No, I did this in like one stream, didn't I? Or two streams? It wasn't too long. Shungite. 5G. In terms of hours, how long did that take you? I don't know. Was it like 8? 6 to 9. Probably. Prints would work? Yeah, prints would work fine, but... I did actually do a test print, and it looked really good, but like, as far as merch, in terms of like shirts and whatever, I don't know if that would... Tote bag. I forgot what Easter eggs I put in here. Oh yeah, there's this one. Hi, chat. And... I forgot what the other ones were. What does this one say? Oh, it's mirrored. Oh, caution, void if removed. I wonder if it'd be easier to read if I get rid of the tone layer? Morning, Miss Owari. There was a couple. Oh, right here. There's another one. It says whiskey. I don't remember anymore. Like I said, I have boomer memory now. What do you mean? What do I mean now? You saying I had boomer memory before? Am I on Art Station? I have an Art Station, but I haven't really posted much on it. I probably should. I don't really have like a consolidated portfolio online anywhere, which I probably should as well. Yo, she kinda cute though. What's going on here? Kind of cute. Wonder what her OnlyFans is. She's got bags under her eyes like me. Emotion her face gives reminds me of the artist 1=2. Not familiar with that person. 1=2. Looks like splash art to an MMO. I would like to do splash art for MMOs. Kind of looks like Lisa. I think I subconsciously draw a lot of my girls to look like Lisa. La 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 Lisa. Who? Lisa from Blackpink? La Lisa Monoban? I know when Gears is sleeping because he hasn't liked Lisa post on Instagram. Hey Mona Lea, yeah, I'm doing well. Not completely, but it's there. It looks better close up. I think I'll crop it like right. Crop it like that. Make her eat a squirrel. Thanks, energy. I do enjoy smudging. Oh shit! Bike man! Yo, bike man, long time no talk. Thank you very much for the raid. Hello, everybody. Coming in from Bike Man's channel. My name is Gears Art. I am a professional sushi eater. That sneezes. No idea you stuck me into the partnerships email. Yeah. I think I have that saved on my computer. Let's see here. Oh, bike. I won't be at Twitch anymore as staff at the end of June. Technically now, but at the end of June, then I'm like done, but. moving on, you know? This is the partnerships email. And I had Bike Man in the background here. I actually like the black and white better. But... I threw Mighty Mouse in there too. Right back here. And Mio's right here. You drew that for the partnership? Yep. I drew that one. I did the affiliate one too, which was... Which one was that? So I had this whole idea in mind, right? So I kind of treated it as like an RPG, like the traditional, you know, Trinity style RPG with like tanks, healers, and DPS. And I like to picture the partnership process, or like the road to getting partnership, as sort of like an RPG. So you have the affiliates, or the people, like the adventurers, that are trying to get in to the city, which is like where all the partners and stuff are. So you have all these adventurers running around trying to get into Twitch Town, whatever the, you know, that would be. And the grind is getting like viewers and partners and stuff, so that would be equivalent to kind of like grinding in an MMO or grinding in an FPS or RPG. And then as you progress, you get into town, but your journey's not over. You have to like live in the town and make yourself known. So I had this like whole little world built, like this fantasy world built up that would represent the partnership process, but I would never got to explore it much because it didn't fit in with like whatever marketing thing. You didn't get the affiliate art? Oh, was that before? You probably got it before I made these. But if you go to like the application page, you get these too. So like the staff are little amalgamations of Little Witch Academia and Harry Potter. So you have... Oh, that's the bits one. Where's the... Oh, right here. Status unknown. So you have like three different... It's like a little animation. So when you first apply, you get this little page, which is just like the application process. So this little staff member is going through all the little applications. And then when you check back, she's waiting for the approval. And then once she gets approval, she stamps it and then sends you over your acceptance letter. And I thought that would be kind of cool too, but... Oh well. Different times. Where's the scheming owl? No, it wasn't my decision for that. How long did it take you? Probably a couple days for the bigger ones, but... the application ones only took like a day. Marketing always ruins awesome stuff and whitewashes it to generic. Yeah, a bike. That's what's... I don't know. That's sort of what's going on now, I think. There's still some cool stuff coming out from the creative team, but a lot of it is being outsourced and like agencies are taking it over and all that stuff. So there's no real room for me anymore in terms of community type art. So I gotta move on. But I have a cool project that I'm joining. And then I'm going to start taking on commissions, freelance a little bit more. And trying to stream more, trying to start my comic. So I've got a full plate. It's just different work. Because if I'm entirely honest, like, the type of stuff that I've been doing at Twitch for the last couple years, I haven't really been enjoying it. It's not the type of artwork that I want to do. I think they kind of knew that too, so. Cyberpunk 2? Yeah. Comic? Yeah. Well, if you are familiar with the webtoon format, where it's like vertical reading, that's what it'll be. If you want to do comic writing collabs, yeah, for sure in the future, Vike. I plan to make it sort of my goal to be doing that sort of like full time, but there's certain other things that I want to do first. In terms of story, I have two potential storylines that I'm working on. One is more of a hard science fiction, and then the other is more of a fantasy, like not your typical Western fantasy, but more of a, it's like an adventure fantasy. If you think like Journey to the West and that type of thing. I'm trying to combine my Asian and Western influence, since I've grown up in both, or existed in both, or exist as both. I'm not gone yet. Gears, you have a webtoon. Yokai isn't paying attention. She hangs out in Discord with us every day. She's still asking all these questions, not listening to what I'm saying. She asks a question and then she like ditches. And then she'll come back and ask something completely different. You always ditch. You're like, would you stay with your significant other if they blew up your dog? And then she'll leave. And then 20 minutes later, she'll come back and be like, would you stay with your significant other if they ate your pizza? It's like, what? In the meantime, we'll had like a 20-minute conversation about her first question, and she'll completely ignore all the answers and replies. I'm just teasing. Mostly. I shouldn't be working on this. I should be working on what I'm supposed to be doing. Emotes. But you know how it is. Thank you. It's a druid. Yeah, she sort of turned into a druid. Looks like she has Christmas lights on her head. She started out as something completely different, but I was gonna go sci-fi with it first, and then I started putting on these little thingies, and they're like, "Oh, is that a deer girl?" And then they're like, "No, it's a lobster crab lady." And they're like, "What?" So now she's a druid. She looks like one of your ex-girlfriends. Uh-oh. Did I change it? You've read Journey to the West. Have you seen the show Monkey Cult Classic? I don't think so. I just use Journey to the West as a reference. Because that's what, like, Akira Toriyama did with Dragon Ball. So, like, the original Dragon Ball was essentially just, like, his version or, like, his imagining of, or heavily influenced and referenced to Journey to the West. So I was just using that as sort of, like, an example. Like, I want an adventure story, but not in the traditional Western fantasy Lord of the Rings style. Yeah, where Sun Wukong comes from. Talk to you yesterday about Webtoon. I expect to have 100 chapters today. Dude, if I could draw 100 chapters in a day, I'd be rich, right? I would be living in a asteroid base surrounded by robot waifus. Living on a drawing table? Yeah, pretty much. Let's give her... What should we give her? Should she have tats? Give her some, like... nature-y looking tats, right? She's a hipster. Or, not a hipster, a hippie. She's got, like... henna tattoos. Glowing? You want glowing tattoos? Gaussian blur. vines. Night, you okay? I just realized it was pretty late. I got a late start though. You say Cybergirl merch, but like what specifically? That would determine whether I make it or not, because like I don't know if it would work as a t-shirt. It would have to be like direct print. Back of a shirt? See, that's, I don't know though, like, there's too much detail, it would just get washed out. A big holographic sticker? Oh, the desert punk girl. Hey, Lados. Oh, what time is it for me? It is 2:16 a.m. West Coast. Am I doing commissions? I am, but like not. This isn't a commission. And I'm not taking any commissions right now, but I am working on some commissions. That's probably like completely useless information for you, but. Yes, but no. Would I be able to commission you to overhaul all my emotes and do whatever you want with them? Next month, yeah. This month is booked. I'm overhauling Anthony's emotes. I'm making some new ones for Lyric. I have to work on a contest entry for Baru. I have a full plate. Oh, and I have to finish doing some illustrations for a secret project. Super secret. Hey, extra large double double. Ooh, dude. I want a burger right now. Just had to come in here with that name. Yeah, bike. Whenever. Since I'm very forgetful, you'll probably just want to, like, bug me. So I remember. Secrets. It's not a burger, it's a coffee. Well, I'd like a coffee too. I'll take a burger and a coffee, since you're offering. Yeah, Vovo-san, I'm gonna do a piece this week. I'll stream it. I'm gonna start on it like towards the end of this week, so I could get it done before June, the deadline. What's the deadline for that thing? Art contest. June 2nd. So I have until June. I want to get it done before June 1st, which is when? Tuesday. So I'll work on it over the weekend, basically. Linear light? Is that the right? Yeah. Tooths. No one loses in Baru's. Baru does contests crazy. Like, that's probably the only. Like, that and I like Baru, but, like, that's probably one of the other only reasons I'd ever enter one of his contests is that. He takes into account, like, the amount of time that people try to put into stuff like that, so. Some people try to run contests sort of like a spec work operation, where they're just fishing for a bunch of, like, free artwork, and then they have, like, one prize that's, you know, mediocre. Like, that time that Shaq was trying to get like a 5-minute animation done, and he was offering like a top prize of $500. I'm like, dude, you're Shaquille O'Neal. You're like a multi-millionaire, and you're offering $500 for like, you know, 3 months worth of work. Are you serious? The contests are great. They're fun for people if they're done the right way, but most of the contests that are run are kind of janky. Like Lyric does good contests too. Like he has, I think, top like 10, usually 10 places. He has top 3 and then like 10 total, something like that. One of the reasons why, yeah, Baru loves art, like art of his OC specifically, but like just in general, he loves art, which is cool. Give her buck teeth. Kind of cute. But no. I'll give her a tongue. Thanks, SCP. Wait, SCP, isn't that the foundation for, like, weird stuff? Is that right? The SCP Foundation? 096. What anomaly is that? SCP-096. Oh, it's the humanoid creature. Oh, the Shy Guy. We got the Shy Guy in chat, guys. Careful. Thanks, Kevlar. Purple's kind of nice. He's got big ears. It's either a snail shell or the poop emoji. Hell, know the truth. Hey, HROLOL. I'm doing good. I am doing fine. Just made coffee. I will never accept the office coffee when we go back to the office. Mel, hopefully you get that the other job so you can get coffee on the way to work. Find like a favorite coffee shop and become a regular. I've always wanted to have one of those. Just like a coffee shop that I'm a regular at. Chilling. You know, I make my own coffee. Alright, have a good night, Bike. Thank you again for the raid. And yeah, just hit me up whenever next month after the second. Wait, what? Oh, you get your second vaccine tomorrow? Good. Good. Maybe I give her a blue dress, maybe? That's pretty neat. Or just like purple. Purple-ish. I pulled Namaste. Hello. Hey, Kerasi. Nose looks like she's got a cold. Tone that down a little bit here. That's better. Can you explain how you are getting the look you do, mainly around the eyes and the nose? Just around here? It's all smudge. I'm just smudging a lot. I'm smudging to like blend in values and stuff and render it out a little bit more. And then just blending in colors, some less saturated colors, some, I don't know exactly what you're looking for, but simplified shapes. I mean, I don't know what. That's a very like general question. That look that I'm getting. I don't know exactly what you're trying to do. Or what you're asking for specifically, I guess. Thanks, Mr. Kirkin. That was what I was looking for. What, just like the technique specifically? Yeah, all I do, so it's the way that I paint, I'm using two brushes. So one brush is just your typical standard round brush with transfer turned on, so the harder you press, the more opaque it gets. So that's what I'm using to put down values, right? So I'll put down value in the basic shape that I want it, like very loosely. I tried to combine roughly and loosely and it said roofly, but I put down value the way that I want it, right? Just like this. And then I take a smudge tool, which is like the blending tool if you're using Clip Studio, but it's a smudge tool in Photoshop. And just taking this same just default round brush smudge tool with scattering turned on in the settings, and then I just take that and I smudge all the colors together until I get like the general shape that I want. And I just keep repeating that process where I just put down value and then smudge it together to blend it in. And then once I get sort of like the shape that I like, then I'll take just that round brush and then start putting in like details. So like for the hair, I'll start putting in lines and then start like overlapping lines. Right? That's basically the process. And then for everything else, it's just normal. Like drawing what you want and blending it in like that. Trouble with skin, mainly getting noses and eyes. I mean, that's just practice. Like noses and eyes, like getting some variation in noses and eyes is important, but you want to just practice drawing them specifically. Like do focused training, essentially. You know how like if you're trying to build up cardio, you do a lot of like running, right? Build up your lung capacity, get your muscles used to working for a long period of time. Same thing with art. It's like you have to kind of focus train specific things that you want to be good at. So if you want to be good at drawing noses and eyes and stuff, draw like a very basic shape for the face. So like, I don't know, just draw a shape for the head, right? Give it a light source and then use this as like a very specific exercise where you're only drawing the noses and the eyes and mouths, I guess. You know what I'm saying? And then do the same thing with, say, like, I don't know, different views, like different angles. So like, if you're gonna take this, give the basic head shape a profile side, right? So like, this is your general profile for a head. Try drawing a side profile version. So just do this type of practice, or this type of exercise, over and over and over and over again until you get better at whatever you're trying to get better at. Same thing with like hands and feet. You want to do the same kind of thing. Exalted? A bear? Oh, from Berserk. Rest in peace, man. Man, that's... I hate it when creators of like IPs and stuff pass away, because you know that they had so much more in their brains what they wanted to do and stuff. Being one myself, it's just like I have all these things that I want to accomplish and not enough time to do it. This is what they need to teach at art school. They told me this is a circle, this is a square. Yeah, I mean, it depends on what art school you go to, but I kind of agree that they generalize too much, and they don't like touch on specifics very often. And even in like life drawing classes and stuff, they just kind of give you a model or a still life and just tell you to draw it. And it's just like, well, all right. They don't like go over techniques or anything like that. Cause they expect you to have that sort of down already if you're in art school. That's why, like, you can get... I went to a four-year degree for illustration, and you can get the same, if not better, instruction if you know where to look on, like, YouTube. Like, you can find playlists on YouTube that cover basically 4 years of traditional art or traditional illustration. But that being said, if you get into the right art school and you find like a professor that you really like connect with or like, you know, just jive with, like that's sort of priceless, because then you're getting all this information and stuff directly from a source that you can contact and like learn from in person. And that's extremely valuable. And that's why I like doing art workshops and stuff instead of going to class. If you go to a workshop, it's very specific and very focused on what you want to learn. Because a lot of the art school stuff, you'll be going in doing things that are completely outside of what your interests are. Like doing learning art history or like functional art, where you're sitting there like making wire sculptures or like doing like woodworking when you want to learn how to draw figures or something, you know? You don't really have a say in what you learn and don't learn. That's sort of what sort of, I don't know, I became disillusioned with the whole art school thing when I started having to like take geometry and earth science. I was like, what the fuck is going on? Like, why am I taking these classes that I took in high school or elementary school and paying out the ass to learn it from some rando at art school? It's like, what is going on? Like, oh, it's just part of, you know, you need the credits. It's part of the curriculum. It's like, oh my God. Ah, my neck. My neck hurts. I guess I slept on it wrong. Art school. When I was in early late 20s, I used to coach art kids who were in junior high and high school. So many of them refused to work on basic stuff. The biggest thing, Yeah, basic anatomy. Like, that's sort of the thing where if you go to a university or a college that's specific, focused on art, they expect you to go in there with like a basic understanding of all the like the foundational stuff. And when I got into art school, like, we actually had portfolio reviews to get into the school to get accepted, because it was private before it got bought out. Like, my third year in, it got bought out by a university. But you had portfolio days where you go in there, and if your portfolio wasn't like up to their standards, you wouldn't get in. So like, that's sort of what you want to look for when you go to an art school, is like, you need to go in there and be like, if they're tearing your work apart in your portfolio when you first go in, that's usually a good sign, because they want a certain level of technical skill, so they don't have to focus so much on the basics. But at the same time, if you're going to an art school that doesn't do that, then by all means you should expect them to teach you a lot of the foundational stuff. And if they don't, then they're basically just taking your money. I have an art degree, but learned nothing. I learned a bit, but ironically, I went for traditional and then ended up doing digital for my career, which is a blessing and a curse, I guess, because it sucked that I had to like teach myself a lot of the digital stuff that I had to know. But it was cool that I learned traditionally first, because that sort of like gave me a deeper understanding of like art techniques. Because if you learn digitally, like, you have so many just kind of shortcuts and tools that you can rely on that you don't have if you learn traditionally. And traditionally, it's like riding bike without training wheels, essentially. There's no control Zs in real life. So if you screw up your artwork, there ain't no undo. You have to figure out a way to fix it without that. And that's sort of a really good way to learn. That's why I always, like, if somebody asked me, it's like, what's the best way to get to start drawing or learning how to draw and stuff? I'm just like, you know, buy a paper and a pencil. Don't spend too much money. Just like buy a bunch of printer paper and start drawing using that. It's the moment you start dumping a ton of money into like computers and drawing tablets and software and stuff, and then you start getting frustrated with art and you realize like you're not enjoying it as much as you are, then you're out a bunch of money. So learning anatomy, learning perspectives, proportions, all that stuff is extremely important, even if you plan on drawing just like anime weeb shit all the time. Like, you should at least have a good understanding of, you know, life drawing, essentially. Realism is important even if you're drawing stylized, is what I'm basically trying to say. Hello, Oku. Math teacher says you don't learn math, you just know it. Why don't you know this? You haven't taught me. You should know it already. School doesn't prepare you for work. They always. I mean, school doesn't really prepare you for work, regardless of how good the school is. There's a lot of luck involved with getting a job in art, and that doesn't just come from skill. Like, if you are extremely skilled, obviously it's going to be easier for you to get a job or, like, get a contract work from a studio or something, but that doesn't necessarily always happen. Like, you could be the best artist in the world, but if you don't know where to go and, like, how to approach studios and stuff, you're never going to get work. Isn't the tablet symmetrical? You can rotate it 180 and use shortcuts? Yes. Yep. This is just my style. Yeah, that you hear that a lot with people who they're generally younger, but like people who are just getting into art and just drawing for fun, and that's fine. Like if they don't want to, you know, learn the stuff that you recommend, that's their prerogative, but if they expect to improve at a fast rate, then they need to practice sort of like the stuff that you get taught in art schools and stuff, because that's just how the world works. Like, you can't know how to draw a car properly if you don't look at a car and draw it. You know, you can try to recall from your imagination, but it's going to end up looking like a jumbled mess because you don't have that foundation down, and just like sort of trying to run before you walk. And that goes doubly for faces and bodies and boobs. It's like, if you don't know how to draw the real thing, you'll have a stylized version of it, but it's gonna look janky and people are gonna realize that you don't really know how to draw it. You could sit there in denial and say, it's my style. But that's just another way of saying, I don't know how to draw it properly. This is how I've taught myself to draw it or learned to draw it improperly. I'm not gonna change it until you like get older and then realize that, you know, learning it properly is good, and then you question why you didn't want to learn it properly for so long. That's just kind of like that stubborn nature. Where's Mel going? Just skip the meeting, Mel. You don't need to go. We'll all quit our jobs. Everyone. Would you hit Disney up? Nah. Booba? Booba? I know I can rotate my tablet left-handed, but the thing is I use... Even if you rotate, it's a right-handed world. I don't know if you're familiar with Puri Mio, but I think she's streaming right now. I might host her. But she's left-handed and uses a Cintiq or a tablet. So, but yeah, generally it's like even keyboards and stuff. If you use a tablet with hotkeys on your keyboard, it's easier if you are right-handed than left-handed because of the way things are oriented, but you can remap things to, or remap tools to different keys and stuff, so it's easier for left-handed, but yeah, you can get a hand keyboard, which is just like the size of your hand. And then map all those keys to whatever tools you use. That's probably a good idea. Blue. She's a ice druid during the winter, and then as the spring starts to come, she gets warmer and warmer, and then slowly turns into a green druid, and then the winter comes again, and then she has to turn back into a blue druid. Tablet. I'm using a Wacom Cintiq. I got used to use my mouse, the picking tool. Wait, you use your mouse to draw? Or for tools? Actually, that would work, wouldn't it? But using hotkeys is much faster. It's more efficient. So if you want to like draw faster, I guess, learn how to use hotkeys. Maybe the forest is on fire and she's laughing. She's smiling at it. Maybe she lit the forest on fire. With the human loggers still inside of it. Yeah, this is a This is Nuna. Booba. side, Booba. Hey, Machiavelli. This was the sketch that we started with. And this is where we ended up. Hey, Cozy T. Have I ever met Haley at Watasuto? No. No, I don't think so. She be kind of cute though. Let's sign it. And then... Then what? I'm gonna try to wake up on time tomorrow so I can stream during the day. Streaming at night, it's fine, but I don't know if I like it. Mixing up the Haleys? What Haley were you talking about? I'm not sure. Can't tell if her head's too low. Wait, what? I followed for a short time until I lightly, briefly said she was pretty one time. The mod jumped in and banned me. I came back years later and the people were saying all kinds of stuff and not getting banned. She unbanned me. Okay. I still don't know who you're talking about, so. That's better. Portion wise, at least she has a neck now. Her arm might be too long still. How do you. No, she can have long arms. I don't mind. Thank you. Whatever. Think it looks better this way. Right. What's wrong with this brush? Thick triceps? Not really. Yeah. I don't think her arms are that thick. Think her head's a little bit too small. Still. All right. I didn't get any of these emotes. I'll work on these tomorrow. That's what I'll do. What's the current piece for? This is just for fun. Oh, why? What? What? Is there something specific about her that you wanted me to know about, or are you just like talking about her? No, I haven't. All right, fools. I'll be back tomorrow during the day. Follow on Twitter if you want to see when I go live. If you use Twitter. I am going to host... Punkurivio.
So good. Hello. Hi, Daniel. How are you doing? Madness Guardian.
How do I raid somebody again?
Thank you.
Do this. Start. We don't need a raid call. We can just... be quiet. Alright, I'll see you all tomorrow, maybe. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for the raid from Bike Man. I will be back. Alright.